Let's go ahead and get into it. Let's go ahead and start importing some brushes and tool presets, okay? All right, so first thing you wanna do is if you have some brushes you've downloaded from the internet or a friend has given you some brushes, what you're gonna do to open them up is you're gonna come over to your brush palette, brush window, top right corner, you wanna click, you're gonna scroll down until you see import brushes, okay? So let's go ahead and click on that. When you hit on the import brushes, when you navigate, you're gonna find the brush set that you wanna put in. You'll know that it's a brush set because it'll say .abr. .abr at the end is the file extension for brushes. So go ahead and click on this. When you open it up, okay, the brushes will get placed inside of Photoshop in a set like this. You can click on the arrow to pop open the set. It'll allow you to visually see all of the brushes that are inside that set. The good thing about this as well is that you can have multiple brush sets inside loaded. And what's great is if I'm working and I don't want to navigate over here to this brush palette, if you hit control or right click in the middle of this page, it'll allow you to navigate inside any of these sets. Click on the arrow to pop it open and you can access the brushes inside. You can also see there are brushes that are loading outside. You can grab these brushes if you want it, and we can go ahead and make a new group. Okay, so we can give it a name. I'll just leave it group one because I know I'm gonna trash this out. So there, we have group one. Double click on the word and that'll allow you to rename the brush group if necessary. How do we load tool presets in? Surely the same, but you just have a couple additions. So if we come up here to the tool preset icon, it's the wrench with the screwdriver. Click on that. Okay, so if you come in here, a lot of times how I like to bring in brushes is I click on this little pop slider icon on the top right, click on this, scroll down, and then you're gonna go to, I usually replace, sometimes I load if I wanna add to the existing set that I have, okay? So let's just say load for now. So if I click load, now you'll see I have two different sets that I can bring into my Photoshop tool presets. I already have these loaded in here, but what you'll see is if I click on this, the file extension for tool presets is .tpl, .tpl, okay? And you'll notice the ABRs, you won't be able to access it. So the good thing about Photoshop, it will only allow you to see the brush or tool presets that you can actually load. Okay, so now here's what I want you to be aware of. When we get to this window, if you hit load as tools, it's going to load inside of your tool preset. This is exactly the way it always worked in the legacy of Photoshop. If you want, you now have the option, and I highly recommend that you do this, is if you hit import as brushes, your tool presets are now going to come in as brushes. And what's great about this, okay, so you can see it just came in. I have all of these tool presets. They're all stacked in with the rest of my brushes. So if you're new to Photoshop and you're just learning how to digital paint, well, if you download tool presets, brush sets from, let's say, Kyle T. Webster, all those were tool presets that would come over here. If I click on these brushes, what would happen is this. I could work on it and I can draw and paint. Every time I wanted to grab another brush, I would always have to come up to this tour preset. Well, if you had a lot of his brushes in the past, we're talking, you could have hundreds of brushes in here and there wasn't a way to group them, okay? But now we can also, we can have them in the brush presets and they're grouped. And what's also great about it is because I can again, control or right click in the middle of the screen and I can access whatever group that I need. And this is gonna be fantastic because I usually like to have my stuff grouped in sets of, let's say like comic book inking or oil painting, watercolor. It just makes it so much faster. And this is such an improvement to Photoshop. I just can't even express it. Okay, so this is really, really useful. Now, if you want to download more brushes, what's great is Kyle T. Webster has a deal with Photoshop where you can access his brushes now. And if you're a CC subscriber, you're going to get these brushes, which is great. So if you click up here on the pop-up menu, scroll down, you're going to see Get More Brushes. Okay, so click on this. It's going to take you straight to the window that's going to allow you to get to these brushes. So let's go ahead and hit fill screen. So if you look at any of these brushes, you can go ahead and click on something. Let's say, for example, I want manga brushes. I click on this, it's going to download. Okay, now if I go back over to Photoshop, I come here, go back to import brushes, and you're going to see the brush set here. Click open, and it's going to come in as a grouped set. Okay, and then all you have to do is pop open, go inside to see what he has there, and that's the eraser. Let's go underneath, and you can just start drawing and working from there. Okay, and then you click on the eraser, good to go, and that's it. So there are a lot of brushes that were provided. So when you just click on that link, you have everything there to grab from. If you're someone who purchased his brushes in the past, you already have them, you can load them in. And when you load the two presets in, you saw earlier, just load them in as brush sets and they're gonna come in over on the side. If you download it from the website, they're gonna come in already as these brushes organized, ready for you to rock and roll, okay? And one last tiny little thing I want you to see here. If you look at the preview of these folders over here, you have three different thumbnails that make it really advantageous for you to see what it is that you're working with. It gives you a stroke thumbnail, it gives you the icon, and also over on the corner, it gives you the tool. So this is great because it's letting you know that this is an eraser, this is a brush. That's fantastic. So you don't have to keep jumping back and forth over here to the toolbar to switch your brushes back over. Now I can come over here and it's an eraser and I can go back to brush. Again, this is fantastic. This is how it is in many other digital painting applications. And now that they added this to Photoshop, it's just, again, it's just a great thing. Now, how do you turn these on and off? I like having the name, I like having the stroke thumbnails and all of those elements to it. If you come up to this right corner, you click, and right here in this section, you can toggle these on or off. I like to have all three of them on, as I said before. It just makes everything a lot easier for you, okay? You also see down here, you can convert legacy tool presets and legacy brushes if necessary. Even if you do load them in, you can load them in as import. You can also load some of them in as legacy brushes. But they're all gonna come back in as group sets. So honestly, I'm using the import brushes from here on out. And that's pretty much it. And you can also drag and drop these brushes in and out into other sets. So that's another thing you want to be aware of. Just because it comes in that set doesn't mean that you're stuck. If you want to delete a set, you just grab on it, hit on the trash, get rid of it. Okay. And you still also, for anybody who's really new, who does not know this, you can go to Preset Manager. And you can come in here and you can rearrange your stuff as well. Okay. And see right now we have, this view, but we can change it to small lists. We have all of these variations of how we can see these, the brushes over here. Okay. And then you can make a new group and do all of the organization. And then if you come to the top, you can actually go to swatches, gradients, styles, patterns, contours, yada, yada, yada. You can come in here and modify everything in here if you need to. Okay, so this was a quick one. This was to get people up and running with the new Adobe Photoshop 2018. This brush setup is fantastic. It's gonna make things run a lot smoother, okay? So if you found this helpful, what I want you to do is go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below and then hit that bell button as well, because I'm gonna have a lot of things coming out for you guys. I'm gonna have a lot of tutorials that I have planned, And if you don't want to miss it, you want to get into, if you want to see what it is I'm going to provide, go ahead and hit those things. So in the meantime, keep painting, have fun with this, and I'll catch you later.